In recent years, people's interest in all countries on the planet in space exploration has soared. Many controversies have been raised regarding whether money should be spent on space research, while there are many problems in our inhabited planet, Earth, and especially in humanity. There is poverty, financial issues, and still so much attention into space exploration. Why? Join me as I show you reasons why space research is very important. We have seen NASA announcing findings in other planets, solar systems, and companies such as SpaceX undergo space projects. For instance, we have determined the approximate age of the universe. We found water on Mars. We discovered the first exoplanets in 1992. Between the years of 2004 and 2005, three new dwarf planets that exist in our solar system came into our attention, and so much more. But many keep on claiming, what is the point of all this? In order for a space exploration to happen, much money needs to be spent. For this reason, many people seem to raise questions when it comes to space exploration, whether money should be spent on space missions, while there are many issues that are happening in our planet that we haven't solved, and need financial support. So instead of exploring space, money should be spent for Earth's needs. Some others considered that, since we already visited the moon in 1969, we don't need space travel anymore. Isn't it enough? Well, there are many reasons why space exploration is important, and I will try to explain my point of view on this topic and why space research is more significant than we think and vital to humanity. Before we continue with the significance of space exploration, be sure to like or dislike the video so that we can continue to improve and make these videos better for you, the viewer. Plus, be sure to subscribe to the channel so that you don't miss any of our weekly videos. Now let's start analyzing our topic. Well, universe. Can you imagine the feeling the astronauts who first landed on the moon must have felt looking back at the Earth, breaking through into space travel, leaving Earth and defeating gravity, taking steps on the moon? I bet the feeling would be unique, as they had the opportunity to see Earth from a distance and be the first ones to acknowledge it. Imagine being in their position. I think many are jealous that they didn't live this experience. From them, this incident can't be compared with anything else. And while we didn't know at this time, the mission advanced our humanity and raised the interest on figuring out the universe. Only good results can come out of this, as we are learning who we are and becoming strong. But what is the real motive behind exploration? Why do you want to explore and go out of our comfort zone instead of caring only about what is going on Earth? Well, the main reason why the moon landing happened in 1969 is because humans are driven to explore the unknown, discover new worlds, and push the boundaries of the scientific limits. Like it or not, we are by nature explorers who want to push further and challenge the boundaries of what we already know, and we want to learn always something new that can cause a whole new reality. We love exploring the world, traveling abroad, visiting other countries and places, collecting memories and experiencing feelings. The same happens on a bigger level by exploring the universe. We are never satisfied and we always want more. People try to achieve these feats for reasons that are not necessarily rational. A few years ago, we confirmed the existence of dark matter, and we couldn't do that without space exploration. What is the value of this knowledge? It's hard to guess today. And what keeps us going is the fact that we can discover every day something new, and in this way we advance the human race. Imagination remains our most powerful attribute, and we don't want to stay stable in only one thing. That is what we do. We always explore. We overcome obstacles not because we have to, but because we want to. We can't live without progress, and curiosity is in our blood. At this point, we need to make it clear that exploration isn't only about curiosity, though, as exploration is necessary for advancement in general. If it wasn't for the space exploration, we wouldn't have advanced technologies. The space research has led us to expand our scientific knowledge and have development of various technologies that improve our lives on Earth, and also the economy. The world that we have created today is the result of several years' worth of knowledge, much of which has been built through exploration. Without space programs, we wouldn't have access to items that we use in our daily lives. For instance, we wouldn't have GPS, accurate weather prediction, solar cells, camera phones, wireless headsets, computer mice, or even laptops. Incredibly useful tools that we take for granted today. So we need to understand that by advancing our technological tools for space research, at the same time we advance the technology we use for human amenities. The next time someone considers that the space exploration is a waste of money that could be used here on Earth, you must think about all the tools that have been developed as a direct result of the space industry. It contributes so much more to technology than we think, but now you have a taste. By paying too much attention to advancing technologies, many jobs can be created regarding this field. Especially many young people are being encouraged to study science to help technology to be improved. Also, what may not cross our mind is the fact that in space they undergo medical research in order to find ways to cure diseases and prolong human lives, and these experiments can't be done on Earth. Exomedicine allows discoveries to happen, otherwise it would be impossible. So it is vital to keep on exploring, as it could save human lives. So if the achievements of medicine continue, we will have two momentous results: a reduction in mortality and an increase in life expectancy. These admittedly positive results will lead to an increasing global population, which will face problems of housing and food. The fact that we can't address fundamental questions about our place in the universe and the history of our solar system and comprehend where we belong and who we are automatically makes us more intelligent and give to the human race a positive sign. We expand our horizons, and whenever we make a great new leap, like the moon landings, we elevate humanity. We understand better our nature, and we can be protected by threats from natural phenomena. In order to be able to effectively protect our planet, we must first find out why it is so different from other planets, in geology, oceans, and its atmosphere. We need to understand that we are part of something bigger than us, and we have to observe it at all times. As far as we know, we are the only intelligent beings in the universe that has to play that role, the role of explorer. By elevating humanity, we improve the perspective of humanity. And by that I mean that space exploration has encouraged important international collaboration that can help to lessen political tension between different nations. So we act all as one in order to find what benefits us all. The cost of space services around the world are an investment in the future of high-tech industries. But space is an opportunity not only to discover new worlds and build advanced technologies, but also to work together towards a greater goal, regardless of nationality, race, or gender. If we stop working together, we'll stop being human. In 1993, the United States and Russia agreed to merge their separate space station plans into a single facility. So space is a place where different religions can come together. Now let's get deeper to the point, as space research can save our lives. Yes, Earth is in danger and space seems to be the solution. I will try to explain it as clear as I can. We know there is at least one advanced civilization that can destroy ecosystems, species, atmosphere, weather patterns, and everything in general. And I think we all know this civilization. It's our civilization. Humanity spreading out may be the only thing that saves us from ourselves. We are running out of natural resources due to overconsumption. We also treat Mother Nature in a disrespectful way, and we cause environmental damage. Our population and our pollution have severely damaged our planet already, and we are experiencing the consequences of a radically damaged global climate. According to a 2012 survey, most scientists estimate that Earth can handle around, and there is capacity, of between 8 and 6 billion people, and we are already above 7. So you understand that we have harmed our planet a lot. But there still is a way of helping ourselves, by switching to renewable energy sources like solar. And the best way to succeed to manufacture and implement super solar technology is in the freezing vacuum of space. We are able to utilize and benefit from efficient solar arrays here on Earth, so to be in touch with the outer space has urgent importance. Also, there are many asteroids that could wipe out our Earth and us. According to NASA, about one time every 10,000 years, an asteroid smashes into Earth, and it causes a lot of damage. but there are also bigger asteroids that we need to take into consideration more, and feel more worried as a large enough asteroid could unleash a firestorm, filling the atmosphere with dust and making life impossible to exist. Finally, the ultimate cause of destruction, and therefore the reason for expanding our living space, is the transformation of the Sun into a red giant, which due to expansion will swallow the Earth and its other planets. This will happen in a few billion years, but it will certainly happen, even if the previous two have not happened. You can understand that we need to explore to help humanity exist and contribute to the continuation of our species. We need to venture out into space instead of standing still, so colonizing other bodies in the solar system is a way to create a backup of humanity that will survive no matter what happens to Earth. So if we understand the laws of the universe and find other habitable planets, we could save humanity. We need to take care of our survival, and it will mostly depend on our colonization somewhere else. By spending the money on space missions today, we help the future generations establish colonies elsewhere in the solar system, giving humanity another chance. In order to survive, though, we need to have the same conditions with Earth. Scientists have found other planets that look like the Earth. The most well-known and closer to us is Mars. Although this planet is barren and inhospitable, it has the potential to become habitable through the long and complex process of geoplasia. We explore space because it drives us to better ourselves. In order for humanity to exist and continue to be improved, exploration needs to keep on going, as we are always going to learn something new that will benefit us. Space research is the way of approaching the unknown and keeps us interesting in learning always more. That is what keeps us alive. Thanks for watching, everyone. I would really like to know your opinion regarding space research. Are you in favor of searching or not? Do you think that we consume a lot on missions that we shouldn't? Do you agree with the importance of meeting habitable planets for the continuation of humanity? Let me know in the comments below. Be sure to subscribe, and I'll see you next time on the channel.